This video was made possible by Wix. If you are ready to create a website, head over to wix.com/go/infographics to try out one of their premium plans right now. Many of us, at some point in time, have had a computer start acting very strange. There are a lot of threats out there, and many come in the form of viruses. Computer viruses got their name because they act like viruses and replicate. They infect lots of files on a machine and can be spread to another machine by doing things like sending files to someone else or using an infected USB drive on another computer. Then you have worms, adware, Trojans, and rootkits, which are hard to detect and can give attackers control of your machine. Perhaps even more frightening are ransomware attacks, where someone gets a hold of your data, sometimes sensitive data, and makes you pay to get it back. Today, we'll look at some of the biggest attacks on computers in this episode of the Infographics Show, the world's most dangerous computer viruses. Number 1, SQL Slammer / Sapphire. This one caused havoc in the USA in 2003. It's thought that it cost those who were hit, in all, about $1 billion. It affected web servers, leading to bank ATMs crashing, it messed with Continental Airlines' electronic ticketing, and it blocked 27 million people from the internet. Even Seattle's 911 emergency services were affected. As Wired explains, Slammer used an attack on one type of software, but then infected machines would spread this worm through the net. The New York Times writes that what was so worrying about this virus was its virulence. It infected 75,000 servers in just 10 minutes. It was stopped, eventually, by patches and antivirus software, but the creator of this virus is still unknown. It also reappeared briefly in 2016, coming from IP addresses in the USA, China, Mexico, Ukraine, Vietnam, Russia, Venezuela, Argentina, and Thailand. Number 2, Melissa. Apparently, the villain behind this virus named it after an exotic dancer. It began as an infected Word document posted on an alt.sex Usenet group. If that was opened, it would send itself to 50 people on someone's Microsoft Outlook email program. That might not sound too bad, but it created mayhem when emails were being sent at a rate that really messed with companies and big corporations. So much so that in 1999, Microsoft shut down incoming email. Users would get a message such as, "Here is that document you asked for, don't show anyone else," and there was an attachment with it. According to one source, it cost people, governments, and companies in all about $1.2 billion. Now, anyone watching this show should know that you should never open attachments that look a bit sketchy. But it seems back in those days, people weren't yet so savvy. The creator of the virus was caught and sentenced to 10 years in prison, but only served 20 months with a $5,000 fine. Number 3, Anna Kournikova. This virus was the brainchild of a 20-year-old Dutch guy named Jan De Witt. He used the good-looking tennis player Anna Kournikova as bait. You basically would receive an email saying you had a photo of her, but if you clicked on the file, it launched a viral Visual Basic script. That meant everyone in your address book was forwarded the same thing. This affected millions of people and overloaded servers all over the world. This gave the young DeWitt a fright, as he didn't think it would cause so much of a problem. Sources said that by the time he understood what the worm did, he had conferred with his parents and decided to turn himself into the police. He was lucky though, and got away with just having to do 150 hours of community service. The virus was even in an episode of the sitcom Friends. Number 4, Sircam. This nasty worm also made Microsoft Windows systems its target. Again, it spread far and wide as it sent itself to people in your email address book. You usually, but not always, saw the following message: "I send you this file in order to have your advice." What was clever about this virus is that it would choose random files from your computer and send them to others. This was particularly bad for governments who don't want random files being sent out. It said it affected 12% of computers in North America and 11% of computers in Europe. CNET writes that it cost $1 billion in damages related to cleaning infected systems and to lost productivity. It also caused some blushes. No one has ever been arrested for creating this. Number 5, Code Red. Estimates on the damage caused by Code Red range in the billions. Web pages that were affected suddenly got the message, "Welcome to worm.com, hacked by Chinese." Norton explains, the HTTP request exploits a known buffer overflow vulnerability, which allows the worm to run on your computer. The malicious code is not saved as a file, but is inserted into and then run directly from memory. It has been called one of the most sophisticated attacks ever that almost brought down the internet, infecting Microsoft Internet Information Server, which many websites run on. It was what is called a distributed denial of service attack, which means overwhelming websites with too much traffic, which brings them down. According to the Scientific American, it might not have been China who was the culprit though. There were many investigations, but ultimately no one knows where it came from. Number 6, Kournikova. Now we come to the really costly infections. Kournikova is said to be the most destructive worm of all, and it cost those infected around $9 billion. It was discovered in 2008, and has in its lifetime infected as many as 15 million computers. It affected police departments in the UK, as well as the military, and really messed with their operations. It infects Windows operating systems, and it lasted a long time as it kept getting past patches and antivirus software. It's a bit of a mystery to security experts, but they know it takes over a machine and then infects other machines in the network. Number 7, I love you. You have to love the name of this nasty virus. A bit like other things we have talked about, it comes as an email with the words "I love you" in the subject line. Well, that sounds nice. As so many businesses used Outlook, it spread fast because folks opened the attachment. Once they did that, everyone else in that address book got the same email. Not only did it spread quickly, but it also deleted many of your files, including every JPEG and MP3. It reached 45 million people in one day in 2000. It was so big that Ford Motor Company shut down its email. It was a little like Melissa, but it sent mail to all your contacts and deleted personal files. Even the Pentagon, CIA, and the British Parliament shut down their emails. The virus was eventually linked to some young programmers in the Philippines, and it's thought the cost of this virus was around $15 billion. Number 8, so big. This happened in 2003 and included a worm and a Trojan horse all in one. You'd get an email with any number of subject lines, such as re-wicked screensaver or re-approved, and then there would be an attachment. CNN wrote in 2003, "So Big.f breaks virus speed records." It was said at the time to be the fastest growing virus ever. It stopped airlines from operating, slowed down many major corporations, and worried the government. It mostly affected the USA. A cybersecurity expert wrote, "At its peak, 1 out of 17 emails that we were processing were a copy of the So Big.f virus." Certainly, we haven't seen numbers like this before. It is spreading at a very fast rate and the volumes are high. In the USA, 40 million emails were scanned and half of them contained the virus. It said it cost a massive $37.1 billion. And finally, number 9, MyDoom. A fitting name for what some people say was the costliest virus of all time, with an estimated $38 billion in damages. In 2004, it infected 1 in every 12 emails. Spread via email and also via peer-to-peer file sharing networks, it was so big that Google was worried. A reward of $250,000 was offered to anyone who helped catch the perpetrators. People said it was someone in Russia, but that has never been proven. Again, you would get an email and open the attachment, then your friends would be emailed, but because it also got into peer-to-peer sharing, it spread fast. To this date, MyDoom is the greatest virus ever. Speaking of change, when is the last time you updated your website? Now is probably the time to do it. And when you do it, use Wix. With Wix, you can build a safe, robust, fast, and most importantly, modern website. And best of all, you have infinite design possibilities. Wix does all the complicated stuff, and it doesn't just host websites, it has a solution for mailboxes, email marketing, and more. No matter what kind of professional solution you're looking for, whether it's something in e-commerce, music, hotels, events, or restaurants, Wix can help you get it done right. Make that website you've been thinking about, and support the Infographics Show at the same time by going to wix.com/go/infographics or by clicking the link in the description. So, can you add to this list? Were you ever infected by a computer virus? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video called 10 Most Dangerous Hackers of All Time. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!